Hey guys, welcome back to the Silent Beauty Doctor here on YouTube. And in today's video, we're gonna be talking about scalp sunscreens. Now, do you need a special sunscreen for your scalp? What's this about? What should I get? Danielle, what's the tea? I'm gonna give it to you, so keep watching. So, here's the thing. You don't necessarily need a specific product to protect your scalp from the sun. You can use, you know, if you already have this sunscreen cream that you like to use, if it's something that's not going to interfere with your hairstyle, that works. There's certain sunscreen oils. I know I like to use a sunscreen oil sometimes in the summertime because, you know, I want to shine up but also have my added sun protection in there as well. Those work pretty well to kind of, you know, protect any exposed areas of scalp. Now, the thing with protecting the scalp from the sun, from what I've read so far, there are cases where cancer was found in the scalp. It's not as common as maybe other types of cancers are, but, you know, we still want to make sure that we are protecting that area because, you know, who wants to take that chance, right? So, although that you can probably get away with using the sunscreen that you already have in your repertoire, as long as, you know, as long as it's not something that's gonna leave a big, you know, something or another in your hair, you should be fine. But I went out and got a couple of products that were specifically marketed as scalp sunscreens, and some of them, they're probably the same thing as regular sunscreens, but in different packaging that makes it a lot easier to apply it. And sometimes that convenience is enough in order for it to be relevant for some people. So let's go through a few of them. So first up, the Kula SPF 30. Now this is a long mouthful of a name. 70% plus organic ocean salted sage scalp and hair mist featuring Minoy oil and Gotu Kola extract. So this is 2 fluid ounces. I paid maybe about $22 for this on Amazon. In my notes, you can see what I had said about this when I tried it. It's a nice spray bottle. Like, the packaging itself makes it really easy. I didn't, you know, notice anything getting stuck or any jams in there. And then, you know, you go to see like, oh, what's going on? And then you spray it and it's like all in your eyes. So like, none of that crap. It smells really good. It has that ocean sea salt kind of smell to it. I also like that it wasn't heavy. It doesn't leave a bunch of residue. So if you're someone like you wearing braids or any other hairstyle where maybe like your scalp is exposed, maybe you have a middle part, a side part, an inverted side part, what have you, it's not gonna have like a bunch of product showing in your scalp, which I liked. For me, this is not something that I would constantly repurchase because $22 for 2 ounces to me is a lot. But, you know, maybe there's a particular person who has a particular lifestyle that something like this might be for. It is small enough to fit in your carry-on bag. It's below like the TSA, you know, liquid limits. If, you know, we get to travel, you know, as much as we used to before, you know. Anyway, you know, there may be a particular person who this is for, you know, a particular lifestyle. Not for me. I wouldn't want to spend $22, you know, every time for such a small bottle. And again, like I mentioned, you could theoretically use your regular sunscreen products on your scalp, you know, as long as it's not something that's going to interfere with your hair. Another scalp and hair mist that I tried out, now this was sent to me in PR from Sun Bum, and I wanted to give them a shout out because I dissed one of their mineral sunscreens on here for being, you know, kind of bad. And they saw it. They actually sent me a package with a whole bunch of their products with a note saying, all right, we saw your video. We know you didn't care for our mineral sunscreen, but here's some other products that we'd like you to try. So shout out to Sun Bum for being great sports, because I was like, oh, that's kind of nice. You know, a little handwritten note. Very classy of you. So this is their SPF 30 sunscreen spray. So much like the Kula scalp and hair mist, I thought that the packaging on this was really nice as well. The spraying mechanism is very convenient, very easy. This is 2 fluid ounces as well, so it's something that's going to be travel friendly. You know, the spray mechanism, I can't see it getting jammed up because, you know, the product inside, much like the Kula, it's quite, you know, liquidy. So I don't, you know, I can't see the spray getting jammed up. Like, maybe if it was more of like a lotion, then I could see that. But it's almost really watery. So I can't see the spray getting jammed up. But you know, maybe if you got a whole bunch of gel in your hand or something, and then, I don't know, you keep going like this for whatever reason, and then that gets kind of jammed up, maybe, but, you know, there is a cover, and you can keep the cover and keep the nozzle protected. So next up, the Super Goop Poof 100% Mineral Park Powder SPF 45. So this retails for $34. You're gonna get 0.71 ounces of product in here. Now, I think if you're someone with an oily scalp and you find that, you know, your scalp is just like on overtime producing that oil, and you really want to prolong a hairstyle like a blowout or, you know, similar hairdo, this might be up your alley because this can act like a dry shampoo does. The only thing is, because it is white, and to me it's not very fine, so it may require a little bit more manipulation to get it to not show up if you have darker colored hair, or if you have textured hair, or if you have braids in, because it's gonna tell on you, and your scalp is gonna look kind of dandruffy. So if you have like an oilier scalp and you have light colored hair, this might be more up your alley. But also, you know, there are other mineral powders out there that you may be able to get more product for less money that you can just kind of put in your scalp. They may not be marketed as a scalp powder, but that don't mean that you can't use it in your scalp unless, you know, you have specific hair needs and specific, you know, ingredients that you don't want in your hair because you're wearing a specific type of hairstyle. But other than that, pretty nice product. Is it totally necessary? No, but are any of these really? No, because you can use your regular sunscreen and just kind of get it in there as well. Okay, so next up from, I'm going to say Bue, but because it has that umlaut on top, maybe it's more like Bue or something. Let me know how to pronounce this in the comments. But this is their alcohol-free performance sunscreen, SPF 30. This is, like I mentioned, alcohol-free, and it's also oil-free. It's a spray emulsion. So this is something, it's not like the other sprays where it has that nozzle. This is more of like your traditional kind of like spray, which it's gonna depend on the hairstyle that you're wearing. If your hair is parted in a way that you have like braids, this is something that you're gonna, you know, be easy to put in. If you're looking for something that's alcohol-free, this might be up your alley. I know some of us with drier hair types, we tend to, you know, look for products that don't have the drying alcohols in them. So that might be a plus here. It's oil-free, but it does have a greasy, kind of slippery texture to it. And it could, if you have thinner hair, I feel like it could weigh thinner hair down. You know, it really depends on the hairstyle. If you're like looking to make sure that you have volume and you have thinner hair, I would probably skip this because it just feels like it would kind of weigh it down a little bit. But, you know, if you're looking for something that's oil-free, alcohol-free, this is $9 for 1 fluid ounce, which makes it very comparable to, I want to say, like, it's like in between the Sunbum price and the Kula, because the Kula is 2 ounces for $22. This is 1 ounce for $9, or if you, you know, think of, if this was 2 ounces, it would be $18, so a couple of bucks cheaper, and then it's a couple bucks more than the Sunbum spray. It's super small, it can fit into like anything, but unless you have a specific type of lifestyle and certain things that you're looking for, certain ingredients that you're not looking for in your product, then, you know, maybe this might be up your alley. If it is, I will leave it linked below so you can check it out, buy it, and get more information or what have you in the description box. Now, this one from Banana Boat, the SPF 30 Hair and Scalp Defense. Protection for hair and scalp. This is probably, to me, the product out of all of these that I've tried in this video that makes the most sense to me. For one, it's about $11. It's 6 ounces of product. So to me, this makes sense for like a more of an everyday thing. Obviously, this is something that you would have to put in your check bag if you're traveling. If you're able to travel, you know, what's it like, you know, in these trying times? I'd love to know. but to me also, I felt like this would be great if you have braids, because it's just like you just shh and you cover way more surface area. So, you know, you can just like kind of be, you know, one and done, as opposed to kind of like, you know, being shh, 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 and then, you know, with one of these sprays. But you know what? Something like this is not going to work for everyone. But also at the same time, I feel like the bottle is too big for like a hair and scalp sunscreen. But when you look at the ingredients in here, I'm not really seeing anything in here that maybe you couldn't use it on your body. I wouldn't use this on my face. But I'm not seeing anything in here that says you can't use it, that would scream don't use it on your body, unless of course you have a particular irritant to one of the ingredients that's in here. But to me, you know, I would use this on my body. I would buy something like this for my body and then, you know, use it as a secondary purpose for my hair. So out of all of these that I've tried, I would definitely say that the Banana Boat is the best value. You get a lot of product. It's 11 bucks. And, you know, if there's nothing in the ingredients that is a known irritant to you, then you can, you know, use it for your scalp and then you can use it for your, you know, your body as well. Which to me is like, you know, who wants to have all, well, some people do like having a bunch of products. Me, I like having the least amount as I possibly can, because sometimes things do get a little crazy in here with the products when the pee all comes in and it's just like too much. And then I, you know, gotta work to get it away. Get it away. So leave me a comment below. Let me know if you would try any of these products that were mentioned in the video. Would you buy a separate hair and scalp sunscreen product, or you're someone like me, like, look, girl, I'm trying to make sure that every little extra penny stays in my pocket and you're just using your regular sunscreen to, you know, kind of get in the exposed areas of your scalp. Let me know that in below, because would love to hear that. Or if you've never even thought to maybe protect your scalp from, you know, the sun, let me know that as well. Follow me on social. The links will be in the description box, because when I'm not here on YouTube, I'm elsewhere on the internet spreading my cheer. And I'll see you in my next one. Bye, guys.